Hey guys, it's March 7th, 2012. My name is Reginald, also known as Dimcad. Yahoo actually has a pretty good series on some families that are struggling and they're adopting in this economic decline, but some pretty good interviews, some pretty good profiles. Definitely worth checking out. There's one guy, well, this couple, this black couple, I forgot their names, but his name is Kirk. And his new wife is working, but he isn't working. And he lost his job. He had an IT job, and he was working in the field for about 23 years, right? And he's in a situation where he went through a divorce, and he lost his house from his first marriage, and he's dealing with child support payments, and six kids is a lot of kids. I mean, come on. And a lot of people, somebody made a comment that I'm anti-big family, anti-kids or something like that, and that's not really true. If you can afford to take care of six kids, hey, more power to you. I think it's a great thing, as long as you're willing to be an actual parent. Too many people are not willing to be a parent, but that's a whole other thing right there. But there's actually this article is so extreme. The Ritters, they have a $1.3 million McMansion, okay, 4,900 square feet, okay, that's how big this house is, this mansion is, and they haven't made a mortgage payment in about 5 years, I'm talking, what they're doing is they're exploiting Maryland's new laws designed to help homeowners who are struggling to pay their mortgage. And they're also filing for bankruptcy over and over again to avoid paying. And they don't feel bad about it at all. I mean, the craziest part is that the guy, Keith, he actually has his own business called Beat It. Movers or something, where they specialize in actually eviction services. You heard that, eviction services. He specializes in eviction services and foreclosure cleanings. And they have photos of this family and everything. There's another part where they actually have a Bible, and they actually have scriptures highlighted that talk about debt and forgiveness, which is absolutely insane. I mean, come on. Speaking of debt, I mean, Europe is still struggling. In fact, Spain has their industrial output was actually down by more than 4%, which is pretty significant. Like I said, Europe is headed into a recession. They have not solved their problems, and the debt is still there. You know, and the U.S. has a very similar problem. It's a debt. It's a debt. But Australia seems to be doing a little bit better. Their gross domestic product actually increased by 0.4%. 0.4%, which is kind of flat, but still, you know, better than a contraction. And that was in the fourth quarter. Right here in the U.S., the Chevy Volt is basically history. The government provided a $7,500 incentive to buy one. And, you know, anytime the government provides an incentive to buy something, it can't be all that great, because the government's never really provides you with an incentive to buy something that's really awesome. Like, you'll never see a government incentive to buy an AKM rifle or an EOTech scope or something you can actually use. I'm not knocking all electric cars, but obviously this was not going over very well with people. They wanted to sell about, 700 units within maybe, I think, a month or every month. And they were selling more like 1,800. Wasn't doing it. So they're going to shut down production. They laid off about 1,300 people. And it's not a surprise at all. Civil liberty groups are angry that Tennessee is, well, their legislature is working on a bill. I think it's equal access to public property. Well, they're basically targeting the Occupy Nashville movement. And the law, if it's signed by the governor, it's basically going to prohibit people from setting up camps and sleeping gear on public property. But I mean, you know, if you're paying taxes, you have to allow access to everybody. Oh yeah, I was reading about how IBM, they developed this robot called Watson, this computer actually, that actually beat a Jeopardy champion. And this thing can process about 200 pages of information in about 3 seconds or something. Really incredible. But now Citigroup has hired them to to actually advise them on financial matters, which is really, really fascinating. So I guess Citigroup just hired SkyNet. Hopefully it works out better than it did for Arnold Schwarzenegger and and a cast of Terminator.
I think his name is Pete Rowley at a predictive science in San Diego. Had a study and he said that basically there's a 1 in 8 chance, a 12% chance that there could be a major solar storm within 10 years, something like a Carrington event. A Carrington event happened back in 1859. It was so powerful that it actually knocked out the telegraph system. It caused some major disruptions, but we didn't depend so much on electronics around that time, so it wasn't nearly as bad as it could have been. I mean, now we depend so much more on electronics that something like that was to happen, now it would be a lot more serious.
I mean, basically a solar storm could create an EMP that could knock out our entire power grid. Yeah, speaking of studies, the Civil Rights Office out of the Department of Education had a study that showed that there was huge disparities between schools that were mostly white and Latino and black schools. The study showed that African Americans were 3.5 times more likely to be suspended and expelled than their white peers. And 70% of the time when students were referred to law enforcement or arrested, they were black and Latino. Now, were they discriminated against, or were the black and Latino students more likely to commit infractions that would warrant the police being called? I should also let you guys know that Stockton, California became pretty much the largest city to declare bankruptcy. They had a bond default, and I think we're going to see a lot more of that this year and in the following years. So, all right, guys, thanks for watching. Tell me what you thought about the video and the information. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today. Bye.